This is Inside Town Hall, a behind-the-scenes look at city government and the issues affecting you and your family.
Thank you for joining us for this episode of Inside Town Hall. I'm your host, Madeline Shields. Coming up in the program, we learn more about Southeast Technical Institute and the new programs and goals that they have going on. And we meet the new director of the Department of Innovation and Technology. We'll be back in just a moment.
Hi, I'm Dr. Jensen from Falls Community Health, here today to talk about Legionella. Legionella is a bacteria that can cause community-acquired pneumonia. Legionella presents like any other pneumonia with progressive cough and fever. It is often under-recognized and underdiagnosed. You are at greatest risk for Legionella causing pneumonia if your age is greater than 50, you are a current or former smoker, have COPD, are immunocompromised, or have other underlying illnesses. People contract Legionella by water droplets in the air from contaminated air conditioning systems, decorative fountains, or hot tubs. If you have any questions about Legionella, contact your primary care physician or Falls Community Health.
There is a great need for workers in Sioux Falls who have a technical education. And joining me to talk about Southeast Technical Institute is City Councilor Christine Erickson and her guest, Southeast Tech Foundation Director Shelley Unruh. Thanks for joining us for this month's Inside Town Hall. Let's talk a little bit about how did the City Council get involved in working with Southeast Tech?
Well, thank you for the question. And we started having this conversation over workforce development in our community and what there's such a huge need for it. And so starting that conversation, Shelley had reached out and said, I'd like to talk to you more about Southeast Tech, what we offer to the workforce for the city as well as the whole community, and talking about their new campaign that they have. And so as we began to talk, we talked about the needs and the financial needs, and myself and Councilor Kylie really became invested in Southeast Tech and what it does for our community and wanted to be able to amend the budget and offer an amendment for $100,000 to go towards that workforce development. It did pass the City Council unanimously. And so the partnership has now begun and is flourishing on how we can work together in a more collaborative way.
And as a foundation director, that has got to be great news to help you and Southeast Tech create these programs and to move forward and expand your course offerings as well as recruit more students.
It was a great contribution on behalf of the city to also endorse the industry partners as well to get involved in the campaign. I think it just sent a great message that workforce is a complicated issue and it's going to take a lot of us working together to produce viable workforce solutions for our community. And that means city working along with education and our business community members to make that happen.
Let's talk a little bit about what is the NOW campaign. It's New Opportunities for Workforce Development. How did that come about and what's it going to look like?
Sure. Really, the development of the workforce campaign, our NOW campaign, started with a series of industry sector breakfasts that we held. We really wanted to reach out to the business community across all of the programs that we have at Southeast Tech to find out from them directly what it is that they needed from Southeast Tech and to reaffirm what do we do well, what did they need us to do better on, and what were the opportunities that we were missing. And through those sector breakfast events that we held with all different programs or industry partners that related to the programs at Southeast Tech, such as healthcare, manufacturing, construction, transportation, there were three kind of main themes that came out of each one of those conversations. And the first theme was that Southeast Tech does a great job of training students for their career. So the quality of our programs is really second to none. We have 100% pass rate on our boards. We're number four in the nation for our automotive program. And we've received many accolades both nationally and regionally for the quality of students that we produce out into the workforce. So quality was great, but quantity is where we needed to improve. We needed to produce more of those students because we're not keeping up with the demand for our region as far as getting those workforce out in the community. So increase those students, increase the enrollment was the number one theme. We also heard from every industry that there is a growing diverse population within our city, and that's an opportunity for both the community and for Southeast Tech to offer innovative ways to give them programming to be successful and to enter into education, both for first generation or new American students, maybe being the only English speaker in their family, to their families themselves, and how to help them improve their opportunities and continue on a successful pathway. So it is increasing the diversity in our campus, not just to increase the number, but to increase the opportunity for those folks as well. And then what we also heard from industry is we need to create more innovative ways to offer programming that meets their needs. So sometimes we need to amend or revise current programs that we have to keep up with the trend and changes that happen with our industry partners, but maybe we need to create new programming that fit a certain need that they have developed. And it doesn't necessarily have to be a full associate degree program or even a diploma program. Sometimes it is just creating short-term certificates that give those students the basic skills that they need to be successful. And then that company or the industry partner will take that student and refine those skills to their specific needs.
Talk about, in terms of the city, you deal with businesses that are desperate for workers. Yes. You're trying to grow the city of Sioux Falls by bringing new families to this area. The city is kind of in a difficult position because our unemployment rate is so low. How is this going to help move that and turn that around?
Right, and you know, as we see our community grow, we want to have those different educational opportunities. And Southeast Tech addresses that. Oftentimes, maybe a technical institute wasn't always the first choice back in the day. It was always you had to go to a four-year school. And so the programs that are offered at Southeast Tech really address those current needs we need now. And so collaborating with the business leaders in our community saying, hey, we used to have a program that addressed vet tech. That is no longer in existence in Sioux Falls or even the state of South Dakota. We need that, and we need to address that workforce need. Oftentimes, if people go out of state for school, they may stay there. They like it, it's comfortable, and they stay there. We want to have that educational opportunity here in Sioux Falls that we can address the workforce needs that are current and right now. And you know, with working with Shelley over the last several months, And diving into some of the details, they have a proven success. They've demonstrated that they are filling certain sector needs of those business leaders. And this isn't just about Sioux Falls, the city of Sioux Falls, but it's really about the community as a whole, because the business leaders have been donating, they have been giving and helping address what are your needs as a construction company. And there's been great success with that. One of the other things that was that I enjoyed talking to Shelley about is, as we talk about the growing drug problem in our community, how can we catch, how can we meet people where they are to get them the education that they need to get them on the right path, break that cycle, and get them to be an active person, positive person in our community. And there are opportunities for that as well through this program.
I think it's interesting that you talked about that it doesn't have to be a full degreed program, and that certificates can help people, or even just taking a couple of courses or classes that will get them on their way. Do you think employers are more receptive to that as well, since then they can take that person who's committed and wants to learn and then direct them as to how they need them and teach them the skill they need them to know?
Yeah, absolutely. And then, as a matter of fact, I can tell you about one specific program that we did where we created a pre-apprenticeship construction exploration program for high school students. Mm-hmm. So it was offered to sophomores entering their junior year and juniors entering their senior year. And the concept of the model was to really expose our high school students to the opportunities that exist in construction, dispel some of their myths about what it would be like to work on a construction site, and really empower them with some skills and a viable summer job over the summer. So what we did was we worked with 10 contracting partners to sponsor 10 students to go through this pre-carpentry exploration program. And the students spent some hours in the classroom learning basic skills, getting OSHA certified, and then the rest of the time they spent on the construction site. And because we were approved and accredited apprenticeship program, that's how we were able to get a 16-year-old student on a construction site because of their insurance. So that was one hurdle that we were able to overcome with this program. Students got great skills, had a great experience on the job site. All 10 of the students that started that program finished that program and graduated from it. Every single contractor had amazing success stories to share about the students that went through that program. There was great diversity in that program. Of the 10 students that participated, 4 of those were women. So it was a really great way for us to help expose students to the construction program, give them those skills to be successful. And for one company, by the time that program was done, that their student was doing finish work at Augustana on a build project, working right alongside veteran contractors in that situation. So that's one example of a proven model where if you take a little bit of education, give them the basics, and then the company partners with us to provide that further training.
Great. Let's talk a little bit about what some of the 5-year goals are, and then there are 5 areas of focus that you're looking at, and both of you can talk about
this. One of the things that I find very, very important is, you know, college might not be for everyone, but if someone's not aware of the programs that are offered and the opportunities by getting a certificate or a training to get a high-paying job after high school, that's important. And so one of the things that this program also does is it does those career coaches. It puts the coach in the high school and really goes out to seek out the students to say, hey, is this of interest to you? Would you like to look at a vet tech? Would you like to look at carpentry? There's so many programs that are offered and in the healthcare industry as well. And in Sioux Falls, we've got 2 great healthcare systems that employ an awful lot of people. And so if we can give the tools to our citizens and to those high school students and or non-trad students, it's really important to get them the right tools, to get them the job, to be able to make ends meet.
And there's some pretty specific goals that we are going to hold ourselves to, so that when we're through this 5-year plan of the NOW campaign, we can come back to our donors and our partners and the community and say that we were successful by these measures. And the first measure is that we want to increase our enrollment by 30%. So we're about 2,300 students now. We want to get to 3,000 students in a 5-year period. We also want to double the amount of diverse students on our campus. So we want to increase that from 10%, what it is now, to about 20%, and we're well on our way. Just from last year, we've increased from 10% to 12% already. And then we also want to increase by 50% the amount of degrees conferred at Southeast Tech, either a certificate program, a diploma program, or an associate's degree program. And we'll do that by the 5 strategies that we've outlaid in our NOW campaign. And part of those strategies include embedding that career coach within our CTE system and trying to get one that will reach out even further into the community and surrounding communities to help students navigate post-secondary and lead them towards or expose them to the opportunities that exist in those technical careers and the opportunity that they have for high earning jobs. So that career coach will be an important strategy of that. An Aspire to Tech program is another important strategy. The Aspire to Tech program is a program that will take students between the 5th to 8th grade reading level and will help them upskill through developing their English language, math, and comprehension skills, but we do it through the focus of an industry. So rather than just teaching them on general education textbooks, we're doing it through a specific industry language. So our first pilot program that we did this with was healthcare. So those students were learning on an 8th grade reading level medical terminology book, anatomy. So those students, by the time they finished this Aspire to Tech programming, they could successfully complete the CNA certification, and they were at an appropriate education level where they could enter into Southeast Tech, into our LPN program, or if they wanted to go to the workforce, they could go to one of our wonderful local healthcare partners in the community as well. So that's another one of the 5 strategies that we'll use to affect our diverse student population that we want to grow, as well as bolster enrollment.
How are you getting this message out to the students that it affects? Are you going to the high schools, and which high schools are you reaching out to?
You know, through our CTE program and our career coach that we have placed, we do get to work with all of the different high schools in Sioux Falls with Roosevelt, Lincoln, and Washington. So we have been able to share our opportunities and stories with them. We have a good partnership with Lutheran Social Services and have been able to communicate and share with them. The Department of Labor is another one of our partners. And we're also looking to partner with Drug Court with the City of Sioux Falls, because Drug Court has never, it's a wonderful program, but they've never had education as a component of that. Mm-hmm. And so the Aspire to Tech program is potentially going to be that last piece of education to help lift those folks out of a situation and help them continue on a successful path and be able to get more opportunities in workforce than they may not have gotten otherwise without the assistance of the program. Mm-hmm.
So you're looking at not just high school age students, but you're looking beyond to young adults or even, you know, 20-somethings that are maybe on a path to not to be successful, and you can bring them in and train them and work with them.
Absolutely, and it's also about those that maybe are looking for a career change. Mm-hmm. Maybe they see a need in the community that we are in great need of a carpenter, and so they go back and they get that certificate and that training to be able to do something that they really have the heart to do, or they want to change the healthcare industry. And so having those options available here locally versus mm-hmm. having to send them out of state sure. or to a different community is really important for me in my role. You know, as we see technology changing so much and innovation changing, we have to be able to embrace how people are learning a little bit differently. And I know Southeast Tech focuses on that as well, as how can we make sure we have the right tools, the right product in the classroom, and that the students are learning on the most recent technology. And in healthcare, that changes so often. And so making sure that that's available as well, so when they do get out of school, they can be as successful as possible and really maintain a high career that they so desire.
Let's talk about these five areas of focus. There's increase the enrollment over the next 5 years. You touched on that a little bit. How do you do that? And I can't imagine that all these kids are going to come, or all these students just from the city of Sioux Falls. Are you reaching out into other parts of South Dakota mm-hmm. to recruit?
We are. And one thing that people don't really understand about Southeast Tech is that we're actually a net importer of talent. About 24% of our student body comes from out of state. Mm-hmm. So we are an important economic partner with the community, because we do bring in workforce to our community from other states, mm-hmm. as well as surrounding communities. Was what we bring. We draw from about 100-mile radius and beyond of students in the rural areas coming to Southeast Tech. So one of the strategies that we'll use to increase that enrollment is through that career coach, you know, strengthening that program here in Sioux Falls to capture more of the students that are here, because about 30% of the students that go to high school here in South Dakota will not go on to any type of higher education. So that 30% is something that we can really target, and I think we'll be able to effectively do that through our programs that we've established and be able to increase our enrollment that way, but then extend that program out into some of those rural communities as well and give them the same opportunities that we have the luxury of having here in Sioux Falls through some of that career coach program. And then scholarships will be an important component of that, continuing to leverage the Build Dakota dollars that we get from the state to offer opportunities to students to have a full ride education to Southeast Tech. But 60% of the students that come to Southeast Tech could be classified as either low to moderate income. So scholarships are pretty critical for our students to be successful. We do have the highest instance of non-traditional students at Southeast Tech compared to our other sister organizations. About 40% of the students that come to Southeast Tech are non-traditional students. So they come to us with college credits, with other college debt, and you're only allotted so much federal financial aid per degree. And so if you've spent some time at another university or college, it may be difficult to get funding when you come to Southeast Tech and you're ready to try and start a new job because you have debt that you're not able to pay off. And so scholarships are that critical key that will help a student get enrolled. It's that last couple hundred dollars of their tuition that it will allow them to pay. It will purchase the book that they need or the laptop that they need to be successful. So a $500 to $1,000 scholarship really can be the turning point for a student to be able to start an education or finish one.
Is there an opportunity for businesses, for instance, construction businesses, mm-hmm. or, you know, HVAC or plumbing companies that need workers to sponsor a student and make some kind of deal that if we pay for your education, you can commit to working for us? Is that a component at Southeast Tech?
It sure is. We have been working with industry for the last 4 years in partnership with our Build Dakota Scholarship Program. And in fact, last year, we had 23 students that were partnered by industry partners through that sponsorship program. This year, we increased that to 69. So we were able to grow the number of Build Dakota scholarships that we offer from about 70 to 77 scholarships last year to over 90 scholarships this year, simply by working closely with industry partners, both in our community, regionally, and statewide, to partner students and get them the opportunity to build their pipeline through that Build Dakota scholarship program. And that will continue to be an important piece, and we're going to have to work to strengthen that as we're getting towards the last leg of spending T. Denny Sanford's money in Build Dakota.
Okay, well, great. Well, thank you for all of that information. And if anybody has any questions, how do they get a hold of, who should they contact at Southeast Tech if they're interested even in helping with your scholarships or students who are interested?
You could definitely contact the foundation office. You can reach me at my office at phone 367-7464, or you can email us at foundation@southeasttech.edu. All of our contact information is at our website, and we would be happy to work with anybody that is willing to partner to make the Southeast Tech Now campaign and create more opportunities for workforce in our area.
Well, thank you for joining us for Inside Town Hall. And when we come back, we're going to take a quick break. We're going to meet the new Department of Innovation and Technology Director for the City of Sioux Falls. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
In an emergency, seconds can save lives. That's why Sioux Falls Fire Rescue has partnered with Pulse Point Foundation to bring you an innovative app that can alert CPR-trained citizens by smartphone of a sudden cardiac arrest near them. It provides the location of the victim as well as the nearest automatic external defibrillator. To learn more, log on to our webpage or download the app today.
Welcome back to Inside Town Hall. Well, the City of Sioux Falls has a brand new department. It's the Department of Innovation and Technology, and it now has a new director. Jason Reisdorfer is our guest for Inside Town Hall. Thanks for joining us. Christine, would you like to tell us how this position all got started?
Yeah, well, this was a new direction from Mayor Tinakin. You know, new administration comes on and has some new priorities. And so for Mayor Tinakin, this was one of those priorities of talking about innovation and technology and how we can embrace that in our community. Technology changes so fast, and we need to utilize technology to address those changes. Oftentimes in South Dakota, we are a little slow to change, mm-hmm. and oftentimes we're the last one or the last state, and so we want to change that. And I'm really excited to have Jason here today. He comes with a great background. He's a problem solver, and so having someone like Jason join the administration team is exciting for me, being on the council and being able to partner with him, as well as how we can work together to solve some of these big issues in our community.
So many of us are not very technical. So tell us exactly what it is that your job is and what are some of your goals.
Sure. So as Christine said, the big role of this department is to solve problems. And we're gonna use technology to do that. So I think Mayor Tinakin says it really well. It's taking really old problems and hitting them from a new direction. So some of the goals are as simple as taking the data that we have available and centralizing it on a dashboard that the citizens can access anytime. So, I mean, the data has been there forever. We just gotta have a new way to share it with people.
Can you give some examples? Like, what are some of the problems that the city faces? Because frankly, a lot of us, you know, we go about our jobs and we don't know all of the details of what challenges the city faces, whether it's in growth or in development or adding new sewer systems. What is it that we need to focus on?
So there's lots of those. That's the good news. So there's lots of stuff to do. One of the very first things that the mayor wants to address is solving our transit problem. Our transit system is old, antiquated, and it doesn't reach out far enough to get all of our citizens. As the city has spread out, the bus routes don't reach them. So the good news is we've got a great partner that was just announced. The mayor has worked with Harvard, Bloomberg Philanthropies, and they sent us on a 9-month innovation track where they dedicate a resource from their department to work with our city and our leaders. And the problem that the mayor chose was this transit issue. So,
and the transit issue has been one that has been reviewed and task force and new RFPs, and it just needs some fresh eyes. We need maybe some outside help. And so this announcement is exciting for our community because how can we streamline it? How can we utilize our bus system for the whole city, but also making sure that it's something that can be sustainable? And that's where the issue falls sometimes. And that's just one of the many, many tasks. I know as I've talked to Jason that his notebook is growing with things to do and taking in a lot of different directions. But that's just one small example, and there's many, many more to share.
Yeah. One of my favorite quotes is by Simon Sinek. He says, innovation's not born from a dream, it's born from a struggle. And so that's really how this list is being built, on all the innovation opportunities there are. It's all the things that could be just a little bit better than what we've got going on right now. So like the city, as I've gotten to meet some of the folks that work for us, everybody's got great ideas, and it's all based out of a struggle that they're having. We can't quite get there. And so,
it's exciting. It's exciting because Jason's really collaborative. He's very outreaching. And so seeing where he takes this department, I think stay tuned, Sioux Falls, because there's good things to come.
Well, absolutely. And we are closing in on our time. But I think this is so new that people are really going to have some exciting news coming out of this. And you'll have a lot of eyes on you as you move forward and solve all of our problems in the city of Sioux Falls, right?
Yeah, it should be fun.
All right. Well, great. Well, thank you and welcome to this new position, and thank you for joining us. Thank you for joining us for Inside Town Hall. If you have any comments or questions, or you want to get a hold of any of our city councilors, you may reach them online at siouxfalls.org. Thanks for watching.